bow your heads. Dear Heavenly Father, tonight we come before you as we celebrate our high school commencement to thank you for the blessings we received. First, thank you to our administrators, teachers, and coaches. They have taught us more about responsibility, courage, and strength than they did about their subjects or sports. We thank you for our community and the support they have shown us by cheering at a game, waving at a parade, or stepping up during this crisis. Thank you for our parents and families for always being there through our struggles and victories. And lastly, thank you for our classmates. I pray that you watch over every single graduate here today. Bless us with hope so that we move into the future with eager and open hearts. We ask that you guide our steps as we embark on the journey ahead of us. Inspire us to believe in the goodness of life, even when faced with challenges and difficulties. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Good evening, members of the Board of Education, Dr. Williams, Treasurer Huck, Dixie High School staff, Dixie parents, and the 2020 seniors. Welcome to the Dixie High School 96th Annual Commencement, honoring the class of 2020. I would like to recognize our members of the Board of Education, Mrs. Dawn Leonard, Mr. Ron Moore, Mrs. Stephanie Crawford, Vice President Mr. Mike Roberts, and President Mrs. Tanya Lankheit. Also, you'll notice that we have 12 valedictorians this year. To meet the status of valedictorian, students must have a grade point average of over a 4.0. They also must have taken at least one weighted class, as in advanced placement. Over the course of the past few years, this class of 2020 went above and beyond greatness in their academics. Our result is recognizing 12 valedictorians. A graduation ceremony is always a special occasion, the culmination of years of hard work, the result of goals attained, and the acknowledgement of successes achieved. So it is only fitting that tonight we commemorate the road that we have all traveled together these last few years. The 2019-20 school year has been like no other any of us have experienced in our lifetime. Every school year brings with it challenges and successes. And this year has been filled with successes, and yet the greatest challenge we've faced as a school. But I have been reminded every time I leave school for the day and look at the senior rock. Y'all survived the class of 2020 is painted on that rock. And yes, in a team effort that took all of us, staff, parents, and most importantly, the students, to end this school year on a positive note. This will not be the last great challenge of your lives, but I wish you the best as you leave high school and enter colleges, the military, or the workforce. You can overcome and succeed. You will survive, as you did for 13 years through hard work in Dixie schools. Now it's time to share your successes and overcome your challenges with the rest of the world. As a society, we look to you, graduating seniors, to be the leaders and world changers of tomorrow, to inspire future generations that will follow you. So to the class of 2020, may your years ahead continue to be characterized by empathy, compassion, a strong work ethic, and a willingness to take on obstacles. May you always lead by example and work hard and play straight. May your successes be many and your tribulations be few and far between. We wish you the best of luck in your years ahead. It has been an honor and a privilege as your principal, watching you progress and succeed.
When this school year began, I knew right away that the theme for my graduation remarks would definitely be Vision for the Future. Clever, right? Class of 2020. Vision message for all of our brand new graduates heading out into the world. Obviously, I did not see school closures and all of the restrictions associated with the health emergency coming. No vision. I will give credit where it's due to the class of 2020 for painting Y'all Survived on the senior rock at the beginning of the school year. Maybe you don't need any commencement message about vision after all. I would like to be able to stand here and give the class of 2020 the comforting words or the deep philosophical insights that would make the end of this year, the absence of many senior events, and the format of your commencement easier to accept. I'm not sure if those words exist, and even if they did, would anyone want to hear them right now? What I do have is some advice that I've shared with others over the years in admittedly very different circumstances, and a philosophy that has helped me when I've been confronted with adversity. The advice is certainly not meant to make anyone feel okay about current circumstances. I wish I could. Maybe I can just provide one additional perspective as we all focus on a brighter tomorrow. In my years as a coach, I continually reminded players that the only play that matters is the next one. There may be a few senior softball players who remember this line from practices or games last year. Softball games, or any athletic event for that matter, are filled with instances when things don't go the way we hope. Might be a bad bounce, a bad call by the umpire, or just plain bad luck that encourages us to wonder what might have been if things had just gone right. It's only human to have those why me thoughts, and if only things would have gone as they should. Completely human, but not very productive. Many times, those unlucky moments turn into more tough times as our focus on what could have been inspires a poor attitude or poor performance in the opportunities that come next. What comes next is the only thing that we can influence to make things better, and if we are determined, make that period of bad fortune a short chapter in the great book about overcoming adversity to achieve a great accomplishment. You can't make all the consequences of the current health emergency go away, but you can make sure the disappointment of right now does not influence the many opportunities for happier times moving forward. Senior events are special, and there is certainly a lot of buildup for those events because they happen in the last year of your Dixie educational experience. They are, however, not the only special moments in your years at Dixie, and they may not have even made your top memorable moments at Dixie when you think about your school days in the future. Each year at Dixie has provided you with many special moments. It may have been a great game you had one Thursday night. It could have been hanging out one night on day three of band camp. Maybe one was finally figuring out how to complete a proof in geometry, or the day you met your current best friend while sitting at the lunch table in the fourth grade. All of the special Dixie moments, however you define them, will be part of you for the rest of your life. In the end, these unplanned times are the truly special moments that you take with you. Not because of the buildup, not because you think they are supposed to be special, not because others tell you so, but just because they are. These are the moments that are remembered much longer than many events that are planned, and certainly way more important than any events that were missed. We are very proud of you for all you have accomplished, very proud of you for how you have finished this year with so much adversity, and very proud of you for all that you will accomplish. I know that you will be strengthened by the end of this year to make more special moments in the future and focus on what matters the most, the opportunities that come next. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
To the parents, guardians, family, and friends of the class of 2020, thank you all for your hard work. Graduation is the culmination of the work of so many people, and these students couldn't have done it without you.
We know that you are probably just as scared now as you were when you sent your babies to school that first day. But just like they have for the past several years, they're going to make it. Thank you for entrusting us with their care. Thank you for sharing their best moments and comforting them in their worst. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of your students' lives. To the elementary, middle school, CTC teachers and staff that have prepared the class of 2020 for this day and beyond, thank you as well. You all have done an excellent job. To the class of 2020, hi guys, I miss you so much. Most of you have heard me talk a lot over the past few years, so I'm hoping this last time sticks. Well, here we are. It's not at all what you had planned for, and it's not at all what you expected. And nothing I can say will make you feel less angry or sad or change the outcome. But here we are. This is the most in-your-face life lesson I have ever seen. Sometimes everything you've hoped and planned for disappears just like that. I wish you didn't have to learn this lesson so literally, because this is tough. But just give me a couple of minutes to distract you. I know that you think the adults in your life have no idea what we're talking about and what it's like to be you. And that last part is partially true. Everyone's feelings, experiences, and thoughts are different. And by the time you're old enough to realize the adults might have been right about something all along, you'll be at the age where young people are rolling their eyes at you. So just listen, okay? Life can be unpredictable, clearly, and life always throws us curveballs. But there are some things that I've always learned to count on. Love, hope, and fear. Fear will drive you to make decisions. Some of those decisions will be good, and some of those decisions will not be so good. But love and hope will get you through things. Fear will keep you up at night. Fear will make your palms sweaty. But love and hope will get you through things. Fear will make you second guess yourself and people around you. But love and hope will get you through things. Fear is powerful, but love and hope are stronger. To quote Jim Carrey, so many of us choose our path out of fear disguised as practicality. You've probably already noticed people asking you questions like, what's next? Where are you going? What are you going to do? Part of that is because we are afraid for you. We are fearful that we have not done enough to prepare you for what it's like out there. We're afraid we haven't given you the confidence to chase your dreams while still working hard. And we're afraid because life is so uncertain. We couldn't stop this from taking away your senior year. So many of us have plans, and just like that, they have to change. You have to be flexible, or life is going to eat you up. You don't have to have all of the answers, ever. So if in 20 years people are still asking you, what's next? That's okay. We want your paths to be clear, but we also want you to have enough love and hope that when you do face obstacles, you have what it takes to overcome them. We have an unknown, limited amount of time. Use it to follow your own ideas, your own path, and your own voice. Through this, you will find who you are meant to be. It's scary as you start the next chapter of your life to notice that people who have been around you for years are not around in the same way. You'll meet new people. Sometimes people help you on your way, and sometimes people are just in your way, whether they know it or not. People come and go, but fear, love, and hope remain. You have big dreams, and you have the right to chase them. You also have the right to change them. You are unstoppable, but you are not invincible. You are capable of conquering everything you want to do, but maybe not all at once. Stay fearful, stay loving, and stay hopeful. You are the one thing in life that you can control. Take risk, fight your fears, leave room in your heart for kindness and love. Don't rush to judgment. Forgive others, and most importantly, forgive yourself. Never lose hope. You are going to change the world around you in small ways every day. You've already started. I greatly appreciate being part of your past and seeing how your future will unfold. It has truly been an honor to be a teacher for the class of 2020. Congratulations, graduates. We at Dixie are so proud of you, and we love you so very much. Love you. Bye.
Good evening to all the families, friends, and graduates. I would first like to congratulate my fellow classmates on graduating from Dixie High School. I know this graduation may not be what we have hoped for to celebrate our journey over the past few years, but I'm thankful that we still have the opportunity to be commemorated for our achievements and our success. Before we move any further, I would like to take the time to appreciate and thank our staff and faculty at Dixie. They have been the support for our class since the first day of freshman year, and each day they continue to do their jobs to further our success and achievements. Class of 2020, I realize that this isn't ideal, but it is one of the many obstacles that we've had to face throughout our many years together. Hopefully, one day in the near future, we may all gather to remember our good times and great memories we have each made during this stepping stone in our lives. But for now, let us reflect on our time that we've already had together. Each of us has a path for a future, whether it be going to college, joining a branch of the military, or joining the workforce. We will each make our contribution to our community and our futures. I would like to again recognize our faculty and staff for putting in the creative, hard work to make this graduation possible for us based on the circumstances we have been given. Class of 2020, I would like to wish you all the best of luck with all your future plans. There are many paths you can take, not just college. Be proud of the life you begin and work hard to be successful and reach your goals. We each go our own way, but we share the times and memories from growing up together in this great community. I'm sure many of you are eager to be done with this school and move away, but please do not forget the friends, families, and experiences that you have because of Dixie.
Thank you.
At this time, I would like to recognize the salutatorian for the class of 2020, Caitlin Nicole Adams. I would like to recognize the valedictorians for the class of 2020, Brian Robert Blosser. Ashley Nicole Brown. Catherine K.N. Crow. Hannah Shea Howard. Brooklyn Leah Massey. Kaylin Lola McQueen. Kylie Deborah McQueen. Carly Jo Maria Peterson. Lucas Alexander Simone. Lucas Paul Singleton. Lindsay Elizabeth White. Catherine Irene Wilkinson.
Well, this sucks. There is no other way to say it. If you're anything like us, you've probably been sitting around being sad and mad about how this is unfair and upset that so many things are getting taken away. We're entitled to those feelings, but we can't dwell on them forever. What we can do is make the best of the situation, so we decided to focus on a word that has impacted our senior year more than anything else, something that will forever be associated with our class. COVID, that's our word. Instead of being mad at this word, we've turned it into five more positive things. The C in COVID could stand for all kinds of things, crazy, confusing, complicated, or challenging, to name a few. But I chose to focus on something else, confidence. I'm sure there was not much confidence on the day of one of Mr. Hughes' calculus tests, or on a day we had to present something in Ms. Lansdale's class, or even when we had to draw for one of Ms. Farrell's many, many projects, or when you finally had to build a trebuchet for Mr. Huff. But we made it through all of those things. The class of 2020 has achieved great things during our days here at Dixie High School, and I am confident that we will bounce back from all of this and go on to achieve even more in our futures. There was a special person who told me every single day that you can do it. And every single day, I replied with, no, I can't, or this is dumb. But I did it, and guys, we did it. I'm gonna end this with a quote. Do not go where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave a trail. Ralph Waldo Emerson. I'm challenging the class of 2020 to have the confidence to leave your own trail. You can do it.
Hello everyone, I want to thank you guys for watching our graduation. I also want to thank the teachers, staff, family, and friends for supporting us every step of the way. I would also like to congratulate my fellow 2020 grads. We did it, guys. As Kylie said, we will each be explaining a letter of the word COVID. I will be talking about the O. Many words can start with the letter O, like odd, which could describe this year, and let's be honest, our class. Ohio, like the great state we live in, that likes to call for a snowstorm overnight and then up being sunny and 75 the next morning. Like the word Oreo, as in the cookies we use to describe cell division in Miss LJ's class. We love that project because we got to eat the Oreos after, and who doesn't love Oreos? The last word, and most important, that comes to mind is overcome, and I think it is the most fitting for our class. As we know, this year did not go the way any of us expected it to. If you told us at the beginning of the year that we would go to an online school for the last 2 months of the year, and we would each graduate individually, we would have said you were crazy. Many of us missed senior nights, our last prom, and just spending the last few months with our friends before we go our separate ways. Things change so quickly, but that's just how life works. Doesn't it seem like yesterday we were nervous about walking into high school for the first time? We overcame that feeling and walked into some of the best moments in our lives, like winning Houndfest 1 year and winning Powerpuff the next. I don't think anyone expected us to win because we were faced with some pretty athletic and competitive grades ahead of us. Class of 2020, we can overcome anything. Whatever life throws at us, we have proven to prevail and come out on top. We can't let these last few months define who we were as individuals. We have so much more ahead of us in the future. Some of us are going to our dream colleges, some are going to fight for our beautiful country, and others are pursuing their dream jobs by joining the workforce. Some of our greatest moments in life are getting ready to happen. We are going to grow as individuals and probably meet some lifelong friends. We can overcome this feeling of sadness and move on to better things in the future. Do you know how I said it's crazy how everything changes so fast? Well, get ready, guys. We're about to have our lives changed for the better. I can't wait to see what every one of you goes off to accomplish. There are going to be so many more obstacles we have to overcome, but remember, we can do it, just like we are now. Congrats, guys.
Hello, everyone. My name is Brooklyn Massey, and today I'll be talking to you about the third letter of the word COVID, the letter V. V stands for victorious. I know right now it seems like we are doing anything but winning against the virus that is greatly impacting our lives, but it won't be like this forever. I can feel a victory coming our way, not only against the coronavirus, but just in general for the class of 2020. This class has been through so much, even before the virus that took away most moments we were looking forward to as seniors. But we've made it to the end despite this, and I know that we will be strong enough to face any other challenges that come our way. This class has always come out victorious against all the hurdles we've jumped, and I know that we will continue to because of the talented people in this class that I know will accomplish so many amazing things. We really have been a superior class that has taken a lot of victories, like all of our wins at Houndfest. As we part from the school, we've made so many cherished memories, and I know that we will all still hold these moments and victories dear to our hearts. These will be a chain linking us together no matter how near or far. I know our class will be remembered not just as the class of the pandemic, but as the victorious class. Not only did we rise above our bad reputation in prior grades, we rose above a world pandemic and finished our school year. I think we all deserve a pat on the back for that. Victory is in our blood, as a link between us and a reminder that we can do all things no matter how difficult. Class of 2020, always remember that we are and always will be victorious.
I is for involvement, and as previously stated in the previous speeches, I can also stand for impact. The COVID-19 pandemic may have impacted our senior year, but the class of 2020 has been impacting the community and the school district for far longer. Our class has positively represented the school district through our vast involvement. We have been involved in many different activities and extracurriculars, ranging from sports to academics, and clubs to community service. I, for one, have been involved in so many I'd need a third hand just to count them all. Our classes have athletes represent Dixie at league, districts, and even some at state. We have had teammates at the school records in sports they're most passionate about. I've seen role model athletes help the incoming freshmen feel welcome to the team. Many of my fellow athletes have represented our school through college commitments and scholarships. In academics, our students have been involved in many different contests. We've had first place winners in writing, art, and history. Beauty has been brought to the community through the art show. Colorful and informational projects have been given to the other classes insight as to what they can look forward to in biology. Many of my classmates have even tutored other students, helping raise grades throughout the district. The class of 2020 has helped many clubs impact the community. Murals have been painted for our community to see for years to come due to our involvement in art club. Bird Club has built new bird houses for our local park. We have put on shows for the community through drama in the fall and the spring. We have helped younger students in the district through groups such as Peer Listening, Project Charlie, SAD, and Peace Patrol. My class has logged many hours helping the community through participation in the community garden, Camp Connect, and tutoring. As a thank you for the strong support of the community, many will even continue helping out the community even after graduation. Students in my graduating class have organized school-wide sit-ins, projects, and events. We've come together to build floats for the community in the homecoming parade, which we've won first in all 4 years. Our class has left its mark on the district and community through ample involvement over past years. We can't take all the credit, though. None of the classes, clubs, or sports we love the most would be possible without the staff. So on behalf of the class of 2020, thank you for being such a large part of our small time here. We couldn't have done it without you.
On behalf of myself and the rest of the class who didn't receive an honor as great as mine, I would like to thank everyone who made our experience and education at Dixie High School possible, as well as memorable. I would like to thank the parents and community, whose continued support helped us manage our struggles. I would like to thank the teachers, who put up with seeing us for many years to ensure we had a great and meaningful education. And I would like to thank the rest of the Dixie High School staff. We would not have had these amazing 4 years without your hard work. Thank you. It feels like not too long ago that we walked through the doors of the high school for the first time, not knowing what this part of our lives would be like. Personally, if I knew then what I know now, I'd be both overwhelmed and excited. Overwhelmed with the list of challenges I'd have to face, and excited knowing that I managed to make it through them all. And I'm sure it's not just me either. All of us have faced numerous challenges in our many years of education. My point is that we made it. And that brings me to the idea of this speech. D is for determination. It is our determination that carried us through these years of schooling. It is our determination that pushed us through any individual challenges we may have faced along the way. Now we're met with perhaps the greatest challenge yet. What to do now? Much like it was at the beginning of our high school career, we don't know what lies ahead. But if there's one thing that is certain, it's that the determination it took to graduate today will be the very same thing that propels us through the many struggles that lie ahead, whatever they may be. Finally, to my class of 2020, with whom I've spent the last 13 years of my life with, I hope you don't lose sight of what we've overcome. I hope you don't forget about the determination it took to do it. And I hope that as we end this chapter of our lives, we are also ready to go out and continue to accomplish great things. I wish you all the best of luck and congratulations, my class of 2020.
I hereby certify that the young men and women here this evening have completed all the requirements as set forth by the state of Ohio and the New Lebanon Board of Education to receive a Dixie High School diploma.
Austin Nathan Michael Abney. Caitlin Nicole Adams. Yeah. Robert Dale Affelbeck. Emily Elizabeth Baker with honors. Gracie May Birkenauer. Nathan Kane Bittner. Robert Blosser with honors. Devin James Brumball. Ashley Nicole Brown with honors. Cody Blaze Campbell. Jacob Edward Chatterton. Cheyenne Noel Class, with honors. Cooper Wayne Clouser. Maya Ray Kaufman. Trent Xander Cornair. Jared Matthew Crawford. Catherine Kayanne Crow, with honors. Riley Suzanne Dale. Abigail Vidini Dalton. Christopher Donovan. Samantha Ray Dunn. Aubrey Paige Dwyer. Jacob Tanner Flora. Brianna Lynn Gamble. Michael Jared Gomez with honors. Caitlin Sue Griffiths. Jamie Jean Grill with honors. Emily Nicole Groff. Caroline Haley Grubb. Trevor Alexander Hall. Mercedes Rose Marie Hatton. Robin Mitchell Moon Hedges. Davon Albert Hill. Hannah Shea Howard with honors. Abigail Cyan Jackson. Samuel Aaron Kanon. Sean Ray Locke. Caleb Michael Lutz. Tyler Patrick Martin. Brooklyn Leah Massey with honors. Kaylin Lola McQueen with honors. Thank you. Kelly Paige Miles. Michael Mitchell. Tristan Cade Friday Mitchell. Ernest Isaiah Mullins. Jasmine Ellen Marie Myers. Lucille DeVille Nace. Amanda Janine Nickerson. Joshua Robert Nickerson. Zachary Thomas Nickerson. Carly Jo Maria Peterson with honors. Parker Allen Queen. Tristan K. Rash. Grace Elaine Ramsdell. Cheyenne Marie Schroyer. Shayna Joy Skurlock. Haley Lynn Sieber. Samantha Ray Shell. Lucas Alexander Simone with honors. Dakota Blake Simonton. Tatum Rose Simonton. Lucas Paul Singleton. Stephanie Cheyenne Smith. Danny Clay Sparks. Mariah Nicole Stanley. Bailey Ellen Stout. Carter Paul Stout. Gage Michael Richard Stoltz. Autumn Meadow Thacker. Caroline Alexis Thompson. Ian Riley Kane Timmons. Jessica Michelle Todd. Thomas Andrew Walters. Lindsay Elizabeth White. Catherine Irene Wilkinson. Madison May Ruth Williams. Jacob Andrew Woodyard. Malachi Michael Yates.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for guiding the class of 2020 through the last 13 years. You brought us into the world at a time of war, and today we earn our diplomas during a pandemic. You have kept each one of us safe through every challenge we've been faced with. You gave us the gift of a secure school, caring teachers and faculty, and the friendship of classmates to walk alongside us.
As we take our steps into our next journey, I ask that you grant us wisdom and strength to make wise decisions that will lead us to success. May we never forget our first chapter and the people you blessed us with. In your name we pray. Amen.